acids and you must transport them in that condition when they are chilled. You can do that, but unless that requires chilling, the specimen will be transported at room temperature. These days, I know we are transporting a lot of specimens to our central public health for viral load tests, sequencing tests, and so forth. Okay? And those conditions must be observed. If you are to use a cryovial for that test that requires that temperature, do it. But if you are sending for DBS, where you have to do it yourself for the child to know the status of HIV, please follow that transportation requirements. And because of the deteriorating effects of light, of photosensitive analytes, for example, here for chemistry, remember, if they want us to measure the room is light sensitive. So you transport it either covered in the back, and if you know, after you've separated and harvested your sample, like serum or plasma, to store it in that. So that condition can affect the patient. If you expose it to light, you will get low results. Okay? Serum specimens should be allowed to fully clot. This is very important. Prior to centrifugation. Some people have been asked, after collecting a sample for LFTs, for RFTs, or for any other test that requires serum, how long is it going to take? 1 hour. But how will you get it? Then, in 1 hour, what they do is to force clotting, and in that process, they force the separation and it will lead to hemolysis, isn't it? So you allow it at least 30 to 60 minutes to clot. Then, for optimal specimen quality, serum or plasma should be separated from cells as soon as possible. When you finish centrifugation, immediately you separate. If you don't, I can tell you somebody who received a specimen for electrolytes on a Friday. This was in a plain tube. He put it in the fridge. On Monday, he centrifuged and gave out results. Do you know what potassium was? 23 millimoles per liter. Reference range? 3.5 to what? To 5.5, whatever you want to call it. Millimoles. So, and he was happy to give out results. And unfortunately, he gave me the results. The patient belonged to me. Then I looked at the values. I said that probably this patient is in the mortuary. Isn't it? That's what it was. Or it meant. But truly the patient was alive. So those results were completely wrong. And if definitely I had taken them to the doctor, he would think I'm crazy. Because he would first ask me whether the patient is in the mortuary. Or he would feel sorry, knowing the patient died. Okay? So, please. General chemistry specimens should be centrifuged and separated within 8 hours of collection. The other analytes that can be affected by prolonged exposure to red blood cells, we have them, And I know especially electrolytes and enzymes, liver enzymes, or other enzymes will be affected. Okay?